It's a compelling story that you might find it of a surprise to you. I was looking forward to join the workforce and join this company, and I joined the company and I was so excited. Down the track, I started to realize that the senior management are not qualified as I thought they would be. Down the track, I realized that it doesn't matter what I do, nobody can see what I'm doing. Later on down the track, I realized that the culture of the organization that I'm in is completely toxic, and it's not just affecting me here at work, it's affecting me at my personal life. Another similar story that you might find surprising for you is I met some person, and from day one, I could just feel the click. I know that's the right person I want to be with. Down the track, I realized this person had nothing to do with the person I wanted to be with. So quick realizations when awareness arises that you are in the wrong place. And the question that I get often all the time, Joe, can you give me an advice or help me? How do I get practically of the situation I'm in? So today I will be sharing with you a couple of tips that I have used in the past and they work for so many people. Hopefully they can release you if you're facing those circumstances. My conversation today is more to the employee, to the team member that has been facing that scenario. What can you do to get yourself out of it? If you are a manager and you're facing the same scenario from someone who's above you, what can you do to get yourself out? It doesn't matter who you really are. If you are not in power to hold the magic stick and change the organization culture with a magic wand on the spot, then you probably would want to be listening and following a particular structured approach to get yourself to safety. How do I get myself out of the scenario from that toxic culture? Tip number one I'm going to give you is expect the unexpected. Or in other words, do not expect anything. Remove expectations completely. That will help you. And what will help you applying this rule is to understand the equilibrium in a journey that is not necessarily a snapshot equilibrium at each phase. Let's look at these three constraints that we face in our life. One is time, money or wealth, health. When a baby is born, they have all the time in the world to play. They also have all the energy and all the health in the world, but they don't really have any money. Let's go halfway through the cycle and we look at the three factors again. Someone in their midlife cycle, extremely successful, they will have wealth, they will have money, they're developing, obviously they're working hard, they have very strong energy, very strong health at this time, but they really have very, very, very little time to spare. When you look at someone who is senior, towards the end, they have spent a lot of time building everything. Now they have all the time in the world. They have a lot of wealth that they have built through the years, but health is declining. So when you look at that equilibrium mentality, this helps you to peace and understand that you are now at a stage that it may not necessarily be equilibrium here, but you need to face it to get to the equilibrium as a journey. So when you really think about it, you can see that we need to understand the concept so we can feel and appreciate day. We need to still experience the night. That's number one. Now let's move on to tip number two. Start taking actions towards removing yourself from that toxic culture. Staying in the environment inevitably will affect you. It's like you're wearing a shield, and that shield is extremely strong now because you're at the beginning, and the longer you stay, the more it will wear out. So I understand that you might have some financial pressures. You might have some reasonable measures that you have to take before you remove yourself from that scenario. But what I'm trying to say is start thinking, start acting. For example, if it was the culture in the organization, don't waste your time or your energy trying to change it. Start thinking, where is the organization that is right for me, and start applying and get yourself ready to move along so you have a very smooth transition from the toxic environment to the right environment where you belong. Bonus tip is that you allow a time of reflection on the experience to extract your lessons and develop an eye for patterns. So when you go to the next organization or you meet the next person, you can identify those patterns. This will allow you to grow your career, grow your mindset, create that higher level of mental fitness, will always allow you to see beneath the mask. If you do have any tip that you would like to share with us, please feel free to share it with us in the comments section below. And stay in touch and stay tuned for more to come next week. Thank you for watching.